Hello and welcome back to my playthrough of the human starting zone of Guild Wars 2. Right now I'm working on a necromancer. This is the fifth part of my playthrough. It'll be out of seven. I'm going to end probably right at the beginning of the level 10 part of the story quest. I just completed an area inside the capital city in an instance where I had to go bail out a friend by saving someone he was responsible for getting captured. Right now I'm just exploring the world, looking at the story, trying out different classes. I believe I'm going to stick with the elementalist, although the necromancer was pretty good. They seemed to do quite a bit of burst damage when they were fighting against me in the battleground areas. And the lich form does protect them from damage, because they can, when you go into lich form, make sure you don't take damage. For anyone that asks, I did play Guild Wars 1. I played as a mesmer. It was my second favorite class I've ever played in any game. I loved the ability to black out, to counter abilities, get rid of people's manas, debuff them. And my favorite ability, Backlash, punishing people for using abilities. The only other class I liked more in any game I've ever played is the Shaman in Dark Age of Camelot. I loved them in RVR. Their entire job in an 8-man group was just to be a dick.
Let's get this stuff back to Pete.
Yeah, here's this apothecary job that was referenced in the last section.
It's dangerous.
Your friend Quinn's upstairs. You better get up there.
It's too rough.
They're going to kill me.
Seriously, guys, we can still work this out. We don't have to hurt the old lady.
I've been keeping an eye on her.
Please don't kill me. I've given you everything you asked for.
What are you doing? We don't need to hurt her.
We do what Pete says, and Pete says she dies.
Yeah? Well, I say no way.
Say whatever you want.
Now, I haven't played much of this class, so I'm not quite sure what I'm doing. The game feels a lot different than most fantasy-style games. You can't just sit back and nuke all forever and expect to live. I'm not dodging at all here, so for a while it's taking plenty of damage, even though this is a pretty easy fight. Basic spam ability is just this attack. Got one that's a channeled chain ability. It reminds me a little of like Arcane Missile from World of Warcraft. My third is an AoE and cripple. My fourth is some sort of cone effect that I'm not quite sure what it does.
Looking good. What's up?
Plus there's multiple waves in this fight. And normally for, it looks like 6 is usually your heal ability. It's on a cooldown, you heal yourself for a significant amount. For Necro, it's 6 is actually your pet summon. And then I can unsummon my pet and heal myself. But it takes 2 cooldowns to use it then. Alright, I can go into my Necro form. I don't really need to at this point, partially I'm just trying to unlock all my abilities. And then I realize that I really shouldn't waste it in case the fight gets harder. Anyway, if you're interested in some PvP footage, I do have some battlegrounds for my elementalist and a thief. I believe I have some world versus world footage saved for an elementalist.
I have things under control, but I'm glad you
let the cutscene play.
As am I. We owe you our lives, Enki. But they took my entire supply of rhizome powder. It's a strong poison.
Poison? Quinn, what's going on? The Seraph will be here any second. If we tell them what Pete's planning, they can stop it.
And there is my cat getting into a plastic bag again. I'm sorry about that noise.
How did you become a rat?
Don't you know I don't know why it recorded that, but not my voice.
I trust Thackeray more than Two-Blade. Come on. You wouldn't help stab one person. Why would you help poison dozens? Be smart for once. Lay low until Thackeray makes his move, and Pete's either dead or in prison.
Right. Listen, thanks for saving me. I'll do what you say and hole up until all this blows over. And hey, thanks again.
I'm out of here.
I'm just checking to see if there's anything else I can do in here. My frame rates in this house were somewhere around 18 or 19. I'm not quite sure why it was this low in an instance area like this. At this point, my settings were on low.
I'm on duty. Heard the commotion. It looks like you took care of it. Please allow me to introduce Countess Anise, advisor to the Royal Court.
Let's go out like a mesmer from Guild Wars 1.
What happened here?
The apothecary's safe. But Pete's gang got away with a lot of poisonous rhizome powder. I feel responsible. I couldn't stop them in time. Let me help you deal with it.
Certainly. You can find out when and where they plan to use the poison. You can shut Two-Blade Pete down for good.
Pete's gang knows I was here. When none of his people return from his job, Two-Blade will be out for my blood.
Don't worry. My magic can disguise me as a common bandit. You can walk among them, and they'll never know it's you.
We'll give you the location of their hideout. It's dangerous, but if you're willing, I know you can handle it.
Consider it done. I want to put Two-Blade Pete out of business even more than you do.
Very well, then. The disguise will activate once you're close to their headquarters. Stand still for a moment while I enchant you.
Well, she's working with illusions and enchantments. She probably is a mesmer.
The scouts tell me Pete's men are hiding there. You'll be on your own, so be careful. Happy hunting.
And of course, simply disguising me is all it takes to fool these guys. I can enter their area completely safe with nothing but a disguise. No one thinks to question me or anything. At this point, I'm doing the caster thing and constantly taking power on all my rewards, which I believe increases my damage. A little inventory management. Everything's out of the instance. And we're back into the open world, in the PvE area.
Centaurs at the garrison gates! Quickly! We're about to be overrun!
Nah, I'm busy. That over there is, I think level 6 or level 8-ish dynamic event area. It's also got a skill point for talking to an NPC and just reading a book. Hey BioWare, look! A day-night cycle in MMO. But you didn't think that was possible. And also, if you didn't notice, your weapons change underwater. I actually have a different set of skills because I'm using a trident or some other weapon underwater now. So, thinking underwater combat actually could be kind of interesting. It does seem to have an issue where if you're on the top of the water, but in it, all of my skills kind of go away for a while. I have to be either on land or underwater. Now, if I remember right, this section I'm going into is actually about a level or two higher than me, so it's going to be doable, but some of these fights will be a little harder. And I clicked the wrong button. Why am I not zoning in? Because I'm an idiot. Try again. Oh, look, there we go. Time for my disguise to activate. So apparently all it takes to get in is a bigger dress and some denim.
Look what the squid dragged in. Who are you?
I'm new. Just got sprung and I'm eager to prove myself. Pete said to check around and make myself useful.
Good. There's plenty to be done. Just make sure you stay out of the way. And if nobody else has anything for you, check back with me. I'll put you to work. Are you talking to me?
Are you talking to me? And the nomination for World's Worst Impression. And that was an example of something I should have dodged. Did half my life, I didn't need to take any of that damage. Avoiding damage, like something to interact with your character to avoid damage rather than just tanking it. It seems like a new concept to me. Or in this case, now I am going to tank it. I'm going to go into Lich form. Or, well, this Necro undead form. And here's where I'm going to find out about the weirdness with being above and below water. My skill bar is gone right now. I have to come underwater and there I have something. Crap, now I have two of them on me, and I only have one skill unlocked. Which is why I'm going to land. Now I am starting to use my dodge a little more here, because I'm kind of waiting for my cooldowns to come back up. I don't have weapon switch, I haven't tried many weapons here. There! Good job, I actually avoided a flame. I can be taught. Always funny looking back on yourself and seeing how bad you're being. Alright, I think I'm gonna leave off right after this fight and come back with the next part. Again, I'm really sorry that there was no comment or anything on the first three parts. I had issues recording and didn't notice it until I had already rendered and uploaded the first three. There will be seven parts, and I'm going to be back with part six sometime today. Thanks, and keep watching.